Hello, and welcome to Late Night with Keish Lorraine. Please welcome Eva La Diva.
Hi.
Hello.
I think I am the trashiest one that's ever stepped foot on this set.
Yeah. Have you looked at yourself this evening?
Yes, I look very good.
The Keish does not approve.
You should.
Mm. Well, being unapproved by the Keish is an honor.
I feel very honored to grace you with my presence.
Yes, you should. Shall we get to the questions?
Sure.
Tell us about your name, how you came about that.
My first actual drag name was Gorgesa. Oh. Yes.
Sounds like a Godzilla monster.
Yes. So I was just popping ideas with one of my friends, and they were like, what about Eva? I was like, I love Eva La Diva. It rolls off the tongue.
And it rhymes.
And it rhymes.
Oh, when did you realize you wanted to start doing all of this nonsense?
To start getting into depression?
No. Well, that's later. We're talking about the drag persona. When did you start wanting to do drag?
I wanted to start doing drag whenever I was freshly 20. I came out to Edge, a.k.a. Core. And I saw Imani do a back handspring. One day, I was just like, you know what? I'm just going to go on stage. I'm going to do it. I'm finally going to do it. So whenever I performed for the first time, was a train wreck.
Was it at Monday Night Madness?
Yes.
Okay.
But that inspired me to do what I'm doing today.
We've talked about Monday Night Madness in almost all of the interviews, but let's just explain it again in case someone is, first time viewer. What was Monday Night Madness?
Monday Night Madness was basically like a popularity contest.
Yes.
That's why I won. Whenever you win a finale for Monday Night Madness, you are booked with 7 weeks in a row. Mm-hmm. That is 21 numbers.
So how many times did you win?
I won 3 times.
So 3, that is the magic number. What happens after the 3?
After 3, they tell you that you are not like an amateur performer, entertainer. So that makes you eligible for weekend bookings.
I won twice before it ended. And I won the last time, which makes me Monday Night Madness champion forever.
That we know of.
I claim that title. That is my title.
If we bring it back, would you do a third?
Well, yes. So besides Monday Night Madness, are there any shows that you wish you could do again? Any shows that you miss?
None of them. I don't like any of them.
I can understand that, yeah.
But the one that I would do again, it used to be called Drag Showdown, where it was a lip sync battle against each other. And there's 3 rounds. You take out one person, take out another person, and then you have your final lip sync. And if you win that final lip sync, you get multiple bookings, prize packages.
Did you?
I won the first ever one. And now it's called Battle Royale.
Oh, yes. I know that.
Yes.
Okay. How about, have you ever produced your own shows?
I have not yet.
Do you have an idea? Something, your dream show, what would that be?
I want to do a freak show.
Ooh.
Like all alternative people, alternative drag people. Their darkest moments, their most scary moments. I want to do that on stage.
It may be distraught in some way.
I would not recommend you to come to it unless you want to perform in it. I mean,
oh, you want to dig up the worst feelings of the Keish?
Yeah, I want to, like, your biggest fears is going to probably be like a theme for it.
Oh, my biggest fear is being Kai.
Or being me.
Ugh. Well, I'm doing my best to look you in the eye. I'm trying, but
trying so hard.
So this will probably be a good time to a break in the show and let Eva La Diva toddle off and prepare for her performance. So along you go.
Oh my God. That was so tiring.
Breathe, baby. Breathe, sweetie. It can pull the blood out of you.
That's too much. Mm-hmm. I did too much on that one.
I'll let you choose. Do you want to play a game or get emotional?
Let's get emotional.
Oh, okay. Tell me about your upbringing, where you came from as a child.
I came from Coryton, Tennessee, was born and raised there, and also being I would say Old Testament Baptist growing up.
Struggles. I can understand those struggles. I think a lot of people here watching 100%. Today can understand those struggles.
My opinion on Old Testament Baptist is that it's their way or the highway. Mm-hmm. So whenever I came out as homosexual, my father did not approve at all. We lost contact. We didn't really speak. I didn't go to any holiday parties, get-togethers. So I struggled with that with my father. My mother has been very supportive. I went on Facebook Live and did makeup for a benefit show I did, and my mom was in it. Oh, so she watched the whole thing.
Well, that's good. I like that. Well, has your father gotten any better?
With him not talking about it, it is very okay with him. I just let it go. I know some people can't, but I would rather have a relationship with my father than having nothing at all.
It's a very common tale, especially
right
in this area.
Right.
Yeah. I never mentioned anything to my parents, and they're both gone. And I will always wonder if they knew, because it was never discussed.
Mm-hmm.
But that was a good story. I like the part about your mama. I think your daddy will, as he gets older, be softer.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So have you had any recent trouble?
Yes. I was unhoused and was living in my car for close to a year.
Oh.
And it made me realize of who my real true friends are that actually asked me if I was okay.
Yeah.
And helped me get out of the hole I was digging myself into. It changed my life.
Well, I was going to ask that, did it change you personally?
Yes.
For the better or for the worse?
Mostly for the better.
Good.
Because I saw who actually cared about me.
Hmm.
And whenever I told my friends that I was homeless, they were like, I had no idea. I had no idea you were living in your car. I had all of my drag in my trunk, and I had all of my clothes in a storage unit. I had what I wore every day to switch out and everything in my back seat. My passenger seat was my toiletries, my bags of like sentimental value where I can see it. So I would have to say it changed me.
Well, now that we've been through the emotional,
that was so gross.
Let us play a game.
Work. I don't like games.
A game called the Quiche Questionnaire. Gravy or ketchup?
Gravy.
Stranded on an island and you can only have one piece of clothing. What would it be?
It would probably be sweatpants with my blue tie-dye.
Mm. Everybody loves sweatpants.
I do. We all do. They're so comfortable.
Oh, well. Favorite movie?
Midsummer.
Is that a Shakespeare thing?
No.
Oh.
It's like a thriller. You have to like really know what's happening. You have to really pay attention to it.
Favorite song?
Closer by Nine Inch Nails.
Ooh, I know that song and I know the band.
Oh, you do?
Oh, many a dinner with Nine Inch Nails. You do not want to be there. They
I think
eat
I do.
Like pigs.
I like pigs. Nope.
You're not allowed to have any anyway.
I'm okay. Thank you.
I believe I'm through dogging with you tonight.
Oh, you are?
Yeah. I don't care if you are, but I'm done.
I'm going to stay. I'm going to stay here.
This seems fun.
I
must say, for contractual reasons, that I enjoyed having you here today.
I'm sorry.
I hope you had a good time.
I did. I did have a good time. It was nice talking to her.
Well, good. So thank you, everyone, for watching this episode of Late Night with Keish Lorraine. I love you the best, my baby darlings. Ta-ta.
I'm going to teach you some new slang.
A lady of ill
repute. Ill repute.
Okay. You ready?
Sure.
All right. Here we go. Hello.